一直表达今天的思想，上帝今天的和咱的信息。
This morning, I would like to reflect with you a message of God.
今天我的题目是咱In Step with Christ, the message, the calling of Jesus.
The topic of this morning's message is calling.
咱来看经文是马可福音第一章十六到二十节。
The passage is in Mark 1:16-20.
咱将这段圣经好读看麦哈。耶稣顺着加利利海边去行，看到西门及西门的兄弟安德烈在海边去撒网。伊本来是掠鱼的，耶稣甲伊讲：“来跟得我，我要叫你亲像得人的掠鱼人同款。”伊就放下了伊的网，跟着了耶稣。
As Jesus walked beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. "Come, follow me," Jesus said, "and I will send you out to fish for people."At once, they left their nets and followed him.
耶稣往头前走，看到西比泰的仔雅各及雅各的兄弟约翰在船顶保命。耶稣随即呼召因，伊就将老爸西比泰及伊的工人留在船顶，跟着耶稣去了。
When he had gone a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John in a boat preparing their nets. Without delay, he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him.
这个真的圣经是非常的简单。
These five verses are indeed very simple.
耶稣有一日在加利利海边走路的时阵，遇到两对兄弟。
There was this one day when Jesus was walking on the sea of side of Galilee, he saw two sets of brothers.
一对去撒网。
One pair of brothers, they were casting their nets.
一对去捕网。
Second, they were preparing their nets.
耶稣就甲伊讲。
Jesus told both of them, "Let's go. Let's go. Follow me."
伊就帮伊门，帮伊船，帮伊老爸，跟着耶稣。
And these brothers, they followed Jesus. They left the brother, left the father, and left the boat.
这段经文就是很简单。
This passage is as simple as that.
但是我未明白。
But there's something I don't understand.
这样代志就可能发生。
This event sounds impossible to me.
你做完以后，你出去外口。
You.For example, after this worship, you go out of his church. You saw someone selling things outside. You saw people doing things outside. Then you tell them,
"Come follow me."
Then you tell them, "Come follow me." Do you think they will follow you? If they are not angry, you should be grateful. You're actually disturbing me.But this time, while Jesus was walking by the side of the Sea of Galilee,
he
saw these two pairs of brothers working very hard. The father was in fact beside one of the pair of brothers.
Come follow me.
When Jesus said, "Come follow me," how do you think could it be possible for them to leave everyone, even their father and their hired people? It looks like something completely impossible. But this is something that happened as recorded in the Bible. There's a terminology for that in theology.
Effective calling.
The phrase is called effective calling.
Effective calling?
What does it mean? Effective calling.
上帝用伊的慈爱，用伊满有权柄的声音来呼召咱，咱就接受了上帝呼召。
Effective calling is God with loving kindness and a voice full of authority called us, and we accepted God's call.
咱未明白。
We don't understand. Because we hardly have this kind of an experience. In fact, we have more experiences of ineffective calling. And parents, you experience time and again ineffective calling. You're telling your children, go to bed. They won't mind you.
Computer咯
Don't stop playing the computer.
没听到
They won't listen to you.
来吃咯，来吃咯
Why don't you come and eat with us?
超鱼
These people they don't listen to you.
这个叫 ineffective calling.
You have instances and instances of effective calling.
作为太太
As wives,
看到你的恳求都来
When you see your husband coming home,
都会少个刀杀羹
You ask him to help you out.
以前在 TV 里面 ineffective calling 叫没来咧
So you have another another instance of ineffective calling while he was right in front of a TV.
So effective calling.
We hardly had any experience of effective calling actually in our lives.
So
we don't understand what's going on here.
我只不過等我重新讀這段聖經的時準,
there was this one time when I reviewed this particular passage. Something dawned on me, it came to my mind. That very day that Jesus was walking on the side of the Sea of Galilee, it's impossible that there are only four people there. Beside the two pair of brothers, four of them, there definitely would be many fishermen. But you notice what the Bible says. The Bible seemed to be saying, in the eyes of Jesus, he seemed to see only two pairs of brothers. Verse 16.
He
said, Jesus walked beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew. In verse 19, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. Jesus saw these four people and talked to each one of them. It seemed that Jesus didn't see the other people except these four brothers. Then a realization came to me. What Jesus saw and what we are seeing are probably very, very different things. That's not something surprising. There was a record of the story of a prodigal son. The prodigal son actually squandered half the family wealth.
He
stayed with the prostitutes. He led a very immoral life. In the end, he was bankrupt. He became a beggar. Later on, he went back to see his father. The Bible recorded. From a far place, the father saw him. He was moved. May I ask you? What did the father actually see in that boy that made him move with emotion? When he saw this vagabond of a son who squandered my family wealth, who stayed with a prostitute, who led an immoral life, then when he came back, the father won't be moved at all. Probably the father would be angry. That was in fact the kind of person that the prodigal son's brother saw.
So that's
the reason why the brother asked the father, why did you let him come back? He's no longer my brother. He's no longer your son. That's something amazing. Father and son both looking at the same prodigal son. When we look at things, we have different perspectives at looking at things, and we have different interpretations. What did Jesus actually see? That's why he called upon these two sets of brothers. I don't think Jesus saw four people. He actually saw four hearts. These four people, they have hearts that are different from the others. That's why Jesus called them brothers and sisters. If Jesus sees a different heart of yours from the others, he shall call you. May I ask you, what kind of a heart do you have? First instance, what did Jesus see? Jesus saw their diligent hearts. When you open the Bible, you will notice something pretty clear. People that God called, they are all diligent people.
上帝从来不何就是个变多人为上帝去追赶。
God never called anyone who's lazy.
因为咱的上帝是温困的上帝。
Because our God is a diligent God.
第一眼第九章十七节，耶稣讲：我老爸创大事，直到如今，我也是创大事。
And in John 5:17, Jesus said, "My Father is always working, and so am I."
特别是追赶的老爸。
The Father is a working.
主耶稣是最近的子，
Jesus is a working son.
所以上帝所认的人，所何的人，都是心内实在关于温困为主最近的人。
People that God and Jesus called are all diligent people and are willing to work for Him.
但你将圣经看佢嘅时阵，
and you open the Bible further.
对旧约到新约，
and then from Old Testament to the New Testament.
你会讲真真同样嘅代志，
and you notice a pattern.
上帝何的任何一个人，
anyone that God called，
这个人都是温困最近，
he is a worker.When God called Moses,
Moses the
he was in the wilderness, he was tending to the sheep. When God called Gideon,
Gideon
he was actually working in the field. When God called Samuel,
yes, he could.
He was asleep then, but he immediately responded. Can you imagine?
Can you imagine?
You have actually an instance of a little boy who was asleep, and when you called on him, he responded immediately. He was called three times, and he responded three times. This person is has a responsive heart. In the New Testament, when God called Martha, collecting taxes.
When God called
When the angels were called, called the shepherds were tending to the flock. People that God called are all diligent people. Why? Simple. The more diligent you are, the more efficient you are in your work.
这个真真特别，你那变多，你无作息，你就懒不好作息。
If you're not diligent, you're lazy. The more inefficient, ineffective you become.
你那够作息就哪来哪够作息。
The more diligent you become, the more efficient, effective you become.
所以你叫人创大事的时阵
，If you tell somebody to do some work,
你就扯一关真无谓的人去做事。
You probably should look for someone who is very busy.
教会常常有自己唔对嘅观念。
The church always have this wrong perception. Why don't you find those people who are not too busy? People who are not too busy, they are usually the inefficient, ineffective people. If you entrust any task to them, he definitely will fail you. He's not only inefficient, he's incompetent, That's why if I tell you to do something and you won't do it, I won't call you again. If he persists and he insists he doesn't want to, then so be it. You find someone who's very diligent. God has already given him special talent. He will be able to do things that other people won't be able to do. There's this person, Reverend Stephen Tong. We all know him. You became pastor at the year 17 years old. Who actually know Reverend Stephen Tong by 17? Who would actually invite him? He bought 3,000 pieces of gospel tracts. Every day by the roadside, he worked. He gave the tract and preached the gospel. That's 3,000 gospel tracts.He's a very diligent person who works for God. When I came here to the Philippines, to be a pastor, the first church I went to, there was this sister who later on gave this testimony. I was actually very moved and very challenged. This Christian sister came back from the US. She's very fluent in English.Her Chinese is also very good. When she came back to the Philippines, she wanted to serve God. What kind of a work does she want to? She wanted to be a translator. Because she can speak English and Chinese. But nobody recognizes her. The church actually doesn't know how good she is.
So no invitation.
So there was no invitation from the church. In this, in a period of 1 year, she was just there, seated in the pews and then translating by herself. So when the pastor preached the gospel, she actually translated on her
after
own. After 1 year, then the church actually gradually recognized her, invited her to translate. The first time she translated, people were amazed. She's so amazing, she's good. You actually know this person. This is the director of the Jubilee Christian Academy. People who wanted to serve God. You don't wait for people to call on you. You are someone who is willing, sincerely willing to be of service to God. You want to be diligent for God's sake. I preached my first message when I was 18 years old. That time I was still not yet in the seminary. I was actually the chairman of a student fellowship. That was Friday afternoon. That was our fellowship time. Thursday evening, I received a phone call saying the speaker couldn't make it on Friday. I actually didn't know what to do. Then I actually volunteered myself as a speaker. So during the fellowship, I told them the speaker couldn't make it. That's why I'm here. My first message.
God's timing.
My first message was God's time. My passage was Ruth chapter 1. I remember this thing distinctly. Brothers and sisters, if you want to serve God, it's not so much about people inviting you to be of service to
God.
There is the inner compulsion of diligence that make you want to serve God. Jesus saw in all four of them diligent hearts. But Jesus saw in all four of them this ambition to want to serve God. May I tell you again. When Jesus saw these four brothers, these people weren't idle, they weren't doing anything. These people were hard at work. They were fishing. They were preparing the nets. And there's this voice that called,
"Come follow me.
Come follow me." And they all left their work, left their nets, and followed Jesus. How could that be possible? They're not idle. They're in fact busy at work.
No. These
people were very efficient workers then when Jesus called them. There's only one reason. Because all of them saw that there is a task, there's a mission, a vocation more important than fishing. Then I call that ambition. Each one of us, we need to have two kinds of lives or two lives. This is the life. The first one is the life that we are living right now.
Daily life, daily living.
This is the life. This is the quotidian life. The life that we do every day. We all have that. But we need to have a second life. This is the kind of life that keeps you perpetually unsatisfied and want to do more. If you don't have that particular kind of life in your life, then you're a waste.
我不爱我现在这个命。
There is this one part of us that say, I'm not satisfied with myself.
我爱更好的命，我更好的生命。
I want a better life. That's your
goal. 你有这个desire, 这个梦。
If you have that desire, that ambition,
你开始已经成功了。
Then you're on your way to success.
有这个movie, 我不知道你看到没有，叫做 Falling Down.
There was this movie entitled Falling Down.
这个里面的主角叫做 William.
The protagonist is William.
这个 William 对于现在这个命真的失望。
William was very unhappy with his life then.
因为里面有一个更好的 the better life 要画出来。
He has always wanted a better life that he wished could be enacted.
但是他的生活有真的实际真的 reality 的需要。
But he has very realistic needs, however.
所以当你画下去真的 frustrated, 真的失望，真的失望。
He lived his life every day very frustrated, very upset.There was this one morning when he woke up. In the midst of his frustration, he went to his office. Before that, he went to a fast food store. He wanted breakfast.
I want some breakfast.
He told the waitress, I want some breakfast.
The waitress said, no more breakfast.
Then the waiter said, no, there's no more breakfast available. And very impolite in saying so. William was very unhappy.
No, I want breakfast.
Then he said, I want breakfast.
No more breakfast.
The waiter said, no more breakfast. So they sort of had the feud.
So manager 出来,
the manager came out. William told the manager,
I just want some breakfast.
He said, I just want some breakfast.
Manager said, no breakfast.
Then the manager said, no, we don't serve breakfast anymore. William couldn't stand it.
He took an AK-47 out.
Then he pulled out his gun.
I just want some breakfast.
And he said, I just want some breakfast.
Oh,
and everybody was scared to death. Of course, you won't do that. You won't actually pull out a gun and really force people to serve you breakfast.
但是,
However,
那你心里面,
within us,
是不是有不宽的不忙?
Is there some kind of a persistence there in our hearts?
I just want to be happy.
Is there something like, I just want to be happy kind of desire?
I just want to have a better job.
That I just want to have a better job.
I just want.
There are so many I just wants in our hearts. I just want to serve God better. I just want to love God better.
I just want.
So I just want. If your heart is unsatisfied, and if you really have the heart to serve Lord's kingdom,then God shall call you. These four people, they all work, but they are not really satisfied with their work. They're in fact waiting for a greater calling in God's time. That's why when Jesus called them,
come follow me,
and called them, come follow me, they left everything, they followed Jesus. Brothers and sisters,
ambition.
Your heart must have that big ambition.
But you have selfish ambition for yourself.
You must not have selfish ambition.
You must have ambition for the kingdom of God.
But you must definitely have the ambition for the kingdom of God. When we all pass out of this world, when we are face to face with God, if you haven't done anything for God at all, then you will regret it. You will say, how I wish I did something. You'll probably ask yourself, why didn't you do more for the kingdom of God? These four fishermen, they didn't regret following Jesus. These four fishermen, these four people became the revered four apostles among the 12. May God help us.
Come follow me.
Jesus told them, come follow me.
Come follow me.
Come follow me.
这个位啊不是普通的位。
This is no simple phrase.
其实你注意看没?
If you take a closer look,
早在耶稣跟这四人讲到两句位。
Then Jesus actually told this group of people two sets of phrases.
他这个是, come follow me.
First set, come follow me.
来跟这个。
Follow me.
Because I will make you a fishers of men.
The second one, I will make you fishers of men. These two statements are indeed very simple. But if you think about it, they are not that simple.
来, 滚地瓜,
First, come follow me.
漢文只有四个字。
There are only four Chinese characters therein.
英文更简单，只有三个字。 Come follow me.
In English, there are only three words.
但这三个字，里面有两个真正重要意思在里面。
But these three words contain two very significant sets of meaning.
耶稣爱意思人讲什么呢？
What was Jesus trying to tell these four people?
Come follow me.
When he said, come follow me.
是讲到 the object, follow. The direction, follow.
Jesus was actually telling them the object that they are supposed to follow and the direction on which they are supposed to follow.
Come follow me.
Come follow me.
这个me这个对象。
First, we talk about the object of the following. You follow me, Jesus said. Then me, of course, is Jesus. Follow Jesus. It's simple. Some people can be very spiritual. In the church, for example, he wouldn't actually mind anyone. He will not follow anyone. Because the Bible said,
follow me.
Jesus said, follow me. That's why this person would just follow Jesus. He will not mind anyone else. Just look at Jesus, follow Jesus. In the end, he became haughty, he became arrogant.
They are too spiritual.
This person has a problem of being too spiritual. 5 years ago, there was this slogan in the theological world.
I love Jesus, I hate Jesus. The church.
There's this I love Jesus, I hate the church. There was this slogan 5 years ago. We actually understand what does it mean. I love Jesus.
Jesus is my Savior.
Jesus is my Savior. Jesus is my Lord.
But I don't like the church.
But I don't like the church. I hate the church. Because the church is so cumbersome. It's so filthy. There's so much few. These people are believers. They're still selfish.
Yes.
That's true. We all admit to that.
Yes.
It's true. Church sometimes could be more defiled than society. But in the real world, when there are feuds and there's an arbiter, then the people will listen. But in the church, it's a totally different scenario. But you must remember,
Jesus died for the church.
Jesus actually died for the church.
Jesus
know what kind of a church he's talking about.
But Jesus loved the church.
But Jesus loved the church nevertheless.
Died for the church.
He died for the church.
So follow Jesus.
So when we said follow Jesus, remember, it's not that we overlook everybody else. It's not that we refuse to follow everybody else. The Apostle Paul said, follow me as I followed Christ. Why did Paul say that? Because in this world, no one actually saw God.
He's
a spirit. He's invisible. You cannot touch it.
但是,
however,
约翰一书第一句,
in John chapter 1, it says,
书道约翰讲这句话,
the Apostle John said, it's as if I've held, I've seen, I've touched this very truth. This truth is God. This truth is Jesus. No one has ever seen God.
教耶稣是叫 incarnated 道假肉身.
That's why Jesus has to be incarnated, embodied.
让人看到耶稣，看到上帝.
That people may see what God really is.
梦到耶稣，梦到上帝.
They can touch Jesus. They can touch God.
这是圣经真正重要的真理.
This is an important principle in the Bible.
When we say we follow Jesus,
when we say follow Jesus,
不是说我们目睭完全无看任何一个人.
Again, it's not a matter of overlooking everybody else and following Jesus.
但是我知呀.
But I understand.
我是带着这个人来跟随我的上帝.
I am actually following someone who's following Jesus. Especially among us new believers,
And
especially those people who have been believers for a long time, take note.
These
new believers will keep looking at the old believers because through them you see God embodied. When he sees you living an exemplary life, they believe what God, they know what kind of a true God they're believing in. Because this leader is very good. His life is exemplary and he has God in it. Brothers and sisters, people need to follow Jesus. You need to follow Jesus. But you need to let other people see God, Jesus in you.
Come follow me.
Jesus said, come follow me.
那是一个 object, 不是这个 对象, 这个 direction.
Should the calling come follow me? It's not simply an object. It's a direction. Because I'm Jesus.
不是这个 脚头,
Jesus is not a piece of rock.
是这个 living being.
It's a living being.
也可以走过,
he can walk around.
也走过,
he can.
也可以 east, 也可以 west, 也可以 lost.
He can go to many places.
To follow the direction of Jesus.
So we need to follow the direction that Jesus is walking
on. Yeah,
where is Jesus headed? Then I shall be there. It's not that anybody else, wherever they go, I follow them. Why did Jesus have to tell Peter, come follow me? If you read the Bible closely, Jesus actually told Peter, come follow me 3 times. Not only just in one instance. Just for example, if you tell this one person, come follow me, then the second time the person tell you again, come follow me, not long after the person repeated again, come follow me.
Why?
Why such insistence? Because this person got lost. That's why you have to keep
him.
After some time of following, he just drifted apart. That's why the leader kept insisting, come follow me, don't drift.
The
first instance of Jesus calling was in Mark 1:16-18. That's the passage that we just read. That was by the side of Sea of Galilee.
Come follow me.
Then Jesus told Peter, come follow me. Then Peter followed. Second instance.
In
Luke 5:1-11. Then you probably remember this story. Jesus told Peter, why don't you let the boat go out to the deep so that you will be able to fish. They were able to it's a bountiful harvest. Peter knelt before Jesus. He said, I'm a sinner, depart from me, Lord. Jesus told him,
come follow me.
Jesus told Peter then, come follow me. From this day on, you shall be fishers of men. That was the second instance. Not yet over.
John 21,
that was the third time. This time Jesus died and resurrected already.
Do you truly love me?
Jesus asked Peter, do you truly love me? 3 times.
Peter said, yes, yes, yes.
Then Peter said, yes.
That's
why you have to tend my flock, love my church. Then Peter saw another person beside him. It must be John. Then he asked Jesus. Jesus? John, how about him? Then Jesus told Peter, this person, whatever it is, doesn't matter to you.
You just follow me.
The point is, you follow me. Whoever, however, whatever he does, it's not your business. Your mission is to follow me. Don't drift away and follow others. From that moment on,
come follow me.
And Jesus never told Peter again, come follow me. It's evident from that moment on, Peter never drifted apart again. Brothers and sisters, our lives are indeed like that. Sometimes we believe in God, sometimes we drift away. The first time I heard the gospel, I was in grade 5, elementary.
五尺六尺我伫基督教学堂里面读册，所以认不耶稣。去参加 fellowship， 我参加 Sunday school。
Grade 5, grade 6, I was in a Christian school. That's why I had the opportunity to be exposed to the gospel. I found it a lot of fun and a lot of food to eat. But the moment I got to high school, I began to drift away from the church. For 7 years, I stayed away from the church. Because I was doing well academically speaking. Extracurricular wise, I'm also doing very good. So I'm the cup chairman. I have many things to do. 7 years I stay away from church. I was away from God for 7 years.
After 7 years,
however, because of this special circumstance, I was able to get back to the church. 7 years after that, for the first time I went to a church, it was an evangelistic meeting that somebody invited me to. It's a memorable occasion.
For God so loved the world.
The message was for God so loved the world. It was a very simple message. But I started crying. From that moment on, I never drifted away from the church. Our lives are patterned like that. After following, we changed our mind. And then Jesus called us again. God came to us again. The Holy Spirit called us again. Then we are called again. Come follow me. May God help us. I don't know how many times you have drifted away from the church. But God will never give up on you. Come follow him once again. Don't drift. Jesus said the second phrase,
I will make you a fishers of men.
I will make you fishers of men. Peter was originally a fisherman. He's really a fisherman. Now Jesus is telling him, I want to make you fisher of men.
Fisherman and fisher of men.
May I ask, what's the difference between fishermen and fishers of men? This time, what does Jesus want to change in Peter?
Fisherman.
How about fisherman?
A
fisherman is someone who turns what is alive into dead creatures. Solomon was originally alive. Now that after I caught it, it becomes sashimi.
Sashimi,
right? Oh. Now this live creature became a dead creature for your consumption. This real alive fish now turns dead because of the way you cook it. That's exactly what the fisherman did. This time, it was originally alive, now it became dead creatures in your system.
Fishermen.
How about fishers of men?
上班哦,
there's a difference. He turns the dead into living creatures.
人,每一个人,每年不上的时候,
all of us, before we know God, we are all dead in sin. We are all dead people. But when the fishers of man came over, they hooked us that we may have a life anew again.
Born again.
That's why the Christian world called it born again. That we may be born again, have life again. For me, Jesus was actually placing two important choices right in front of his right for Peter.
Fisherman.
You either become a fisherman,
fisherman
or a fisher of men. Here's one person who turns something live to death. Who turns? The second group is turning the dead.
Make your choice.
You make your choice.
你要做什么样的工作?
What kind of work do you want to do?
耶稣将这个真道的真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真真
Now, are you accepting this important work?
当上帝呼召一个人的时候,
when Jesus called on someone,
以是在从人的价值改变起来,
he actually changes your entire value system.
当上帝呼召Abraham的时候,
when God called Abraham,
这个人是七十过去的老人,
Abraham was a 75-year-old man.
上帝跟他说,
Jesus, God told him,
我要呼召你,
I'm calling you now.
你扎追大国,
you shall become a big nation.
大名。
You have great name.
全世界因为你这个祝福,
people in this world will be blessed because of you.
上帝的这个伟大的目标责任使命交给伊。
God has entrusted the noble vision and mission to Abraham.
Abraham 若无接受,
if Abraham didn't accept it,
伊这个老人死在 earth 的所在, 全世界无人不依。
If he didn't accept it, he will just be an old patriarch who eventually pass away and die.
感谢主伊接受。
We thank God.He accepted
Abraham.
That's why he's called Abraham.
The father of the nations, the father of faith.
That's why he's called the father of nations, father of faith.
Moses.
How about Moses? When God called Moses, Jesus, God told him, You shall be delivered, my people, from the land of slavery. You shall bring all of them to the promised land, the land filled with milk
Moses
and honey. If Moses refused the offer,
Moses is the king of the 70-year-old man,
Moses will just be a mere 80-year-old man who will eventually die in the desert. But we thank God.
Moses accepted.
But we thank God Moses accepted the calling. And then that's why people all know him. When Jesus called the apostles, these are very ordinary people. Many of them are fishermen. Now Jesus said, I'm going to make you fishers of men. We thank God. Each one accepted. That's why they became eventually the apostles.Because of that, the entire world knows. If each one of them refused, each one will die a very normal, ordinary death. Brothers and sisters, when God called us, He gives you work.
Opportunity.
He is giving you an opportunity so that your system's value system will increase. For example, if you study economics, there is a term that you actually must know.
Opportunity cost.
It's called opportunity cost.
什么叫 opportunity cost?
What does opportunity cost mean?It means when you choose something, you definitely give up something. This thing that you lose and give up, that's your opportunity cost. For example, today's Sunday worship service. Suddenly, there was this invitation that just came in. Let's go to Tagaytay, let's play golf. Now you need to make a choice.
Will we worship God?Or park golf?
Do I go to the worship service or do I go to the golf
course?
You cannot have both.
So make your choice.
So you have to make your choice.
你包落的叫做 opportunity cost.
What you gave up, that's the opportunity cost.
你来教会礼拜。
So when you, for example, come to this church,
你没去 park golf.
You didn't go to the golf course.
After worship, 以后,
after worship,
你两个反应,
you have two responses.
他就说, 感谢主, 今天没去 park golf.
You could have said,Thank God I didn't go to the golf. Because a worship service is very helpful to me. There could be that other possibility. You regret it. I should have been in the golf course. This service is a waste of time. Now you have a choice. Many of you are married. Some of you are still unmarried. For example, a sister is unmarried. Now there are two brothers both pursuing the sister. Of course, she will only choose one.
David.
So So the person not chosen, that's the opportunity cost.
So
this sister would have two responses eventually.
After 5 years.
What would she say?
Said,
thank God. This person is fantastic. It's a good thing I didn't choose the other one. That's the first option. There's another possibility. You already know.
Opportunity cost.
What does opportunity cost mean? Everything is dictated by this law. Now that you're serving God.
Opportunity cost.
This thing that you don't do, you don't serve God, that's the opportunity cost. One day face to face with God. There could be two responses to
it.
You say, thank God. I thank God. It's a good thing I chose to serve God. It also could be one of regret. I should have served God. Brothers and sisters, we only have one life. How you are going to spend your life? There's no take two for life. How you choose and what you choose,
this is your choice.
It's your choice. It's very clear. These four people, they don't want to lead ordinary lives. They want their lives to be inextricable from God's kingdom. That's why they accepted the calling of Jesus. When I was 22, I heard God's calling me. I didn't want my life to be just one ordinary life. That's why I accepted the calling. Till today, God is not calling everyone to be a full-time minister. But God is calling on everyone to serve Him.
This is your choice.
It's your choice.
Opportunity cost.
What you've lost is your opportunity cost. Think about it. Given what you have and given what you give up, which one is actually more valuable, more significant? May God help us.
Come, follow me. I will make you a fisher of men. The sea lang, Japsu. To get sea lang, Banglo, Tibesi Jun, Banglo, Si Mang. That's the Isor Titio. The Shong de Inghang Dongan, De Toa Choco, De Toa Silsu. Joa Gun, Gamshadi. Gamshadi, do you Gun to Guanelang, what should Nikake Hotel? Amen.